Since most liver diseases have no symptoms, it is important to be screened for them using blood testing. Most commonly, liver diseases are detected in patients when they get routine physical exam and laboratory testing. We generally use as our first screening a set of liver enzymes called liver function tests or a hepatic function panel. These include enzymes that are inside the liver cell that get released into the bloodstream when the liver is damaged or inflamed. Once we find abnormal liver function tests, we need to search for a specific cause. The most common causes of liver disease in the United States are hepatitis C and alcohol. Other common causes are obesity and diabetes, which lead to non-alcoholic fatty liver or fatty liver disease, hemochromatosis, a disease of iron overload, and hepatitis B. Most of these diseases can be tested for with simple blood testing. For hepatitis C, the Center for Disease Control now recommends that anyone born between 1945 and 1965 get tested for hepatitis C, regardless of whether they have normal or abnormal liver blood tests or any risk factors for hepatitis. Obesity, as well as diabetes, cause fat to be deposited in the liver. This fat can be completely benign or harmless, but in about 20% of cases, this fat leads to inflammation of the liver. We call this inflammation of the liver steatohepatitis, steato for fat, hepatitis just meaning inflammation of the liver. Non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, which is usually associated with obesity or diabetes, and occasionally high cholesterol or triglycerides in the blood, causes inflammation of the liver, and over time can lead to permanent damage of the liver. This permanent damage, or scarring, we call fibrosis, and over time can lead to cirrhosis. It is important to know that any disease or any condition that leads to inflammation or damage of the liver can lead to progressive scarring or fibrosis. And that progressive scarring or fibrosis can result in cirrhosis. This is contrary to the popular belief that only people who drink excessive alcohol are at risk for cirrhosis.